Very good morning, my dear students. I welcome you all for VTU Shikshana program. This is the 9th session on thermal radiation chapter of heat transfer subject. Myself, Dr. Madhukeshwarayan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering Department, Jain Institute of Technology, Davanagere. You can note down my email ID and phone numbers. And for any clarifications or doubts on this chapter, you can contact me. In the previous class, we have solved some of the examples. Today also, we will solve some more examples on the thermal radiation concepts. So the next example is as follows. An enclosure measures 1.5 meter into 1.7 meter with height of 2 meter. The walls and ceiling are maintained at 250 degrees Celsius and the floor at 130 degrees Celsius. The walls and ceiling have an emissivity of 0.82 and the floor is having emissivity of 0.7. Determine the net radiation to the floor. So this seems to be a room. In this room, the measurements are as given. So these are the measurements of a wall. 1.5 meter into 1.7 meter. That is, we can take X and Y dimensions. This is the plan dimensions, 1.5 meter into 1.7 meter. Height means Z direction, it will be 2 meter height. So one wall will be 1.5 meter and another wall will be 1.7 meter. So it's a rectangular room or an enclosure. The wall of the enclosure is having 2 meter height. Walls and ceiling are maintained at 250 and 130 degree. Sorry, walls and ceiling are maintained at 250 degree. So walls and both ceiling are at 250 degrees, whereas the floor is only at 130 degrees Celsius. The walls and ceiling have an emissivity of 0.82 and the floor 0.7. So except floor, all other things are having emissivity 0.82 and the floor is having the emissivity of 0.7. Determine the net radiation to the floor. So we have to find out what is the net radiation to the floor. So given that T2 is equal to T3 is equal to 250 degrees Celsius plus 273, which is equal to 523 Kelvin, which is nothing but T4. And T1 is equal to floor temperature 130 plus 273, which is equal to 403 Kelvin. So you can see that wall temperature and ceiling temperature are 250 degrees Celsius. Those are taken as T2 and T3, and which is nothing but 523 Kelvin, which is also equal to T4. T3, T4. So wall T2, T3, T4 are wall and ceiling temperatures. T1 is only the floor temperature, which is 130 degrees Celsius, that is 403 Kelvin. Now this is the schematic example of the given problem, schematic of the problem. So here you can see the dimensions are 1.7 meter on one side, 1.5 meter on the other side. There is a height is not given here. This is equal to 2 meter. So let me draw this one as a 2 meter. Now this is a wall. This is wall. So this is also wall. This is also side wall. This is also a wall. And this one is floor. So we have to find out the view factor between two perpendicular rectangles with a common edge. So this graph I am using to find out the two perpendicular rectangles, view factor for two perpendicular rectangles with a common edge. So what are the view factors we have to find? That is F1 to 2 we need to find, F1 to 3 we need to find. How to find F1 to 2? Now you can see this is 1 and this is 2. F1 to 2 we need to find. So in it, when it is 1 and this one is 2, F1 to 2, that is between end walls and the floor, between the end walls and the floor. So end walls and floor dimensions you have to consider. So how to consider end walls and floor dimensions? So you can see this is the end wall which is having 2 meter into 1.5 meter and floor. So L2, 2 meter is L2. L2 is equal to 2 meter. And here L1 in this case, L1 will, this case will become 1.7 meter. And width, so what is the width? So width will be 1.5 meter. So W in this case will be 1.5 meter. Now you can see L1 by W. So L1 by W, 1.7 meter divided by 1.5 meter. 1.7 meter divided by 1.5 meter is 1.133. So here L1 by W, 1.133 we have to. So somewhere here 1.1. You can see this is 1 and this is here 1.133. 1.133 is the L1 by W. Next, L2 by W. So you can see that L2 is 2 meter, W is 1.5 meter. So 2 divided by 1.5 meter is 1.33. So this is 1.33 somewhere here. You can mark down. That is L2 by W. That is 1.33. Now for this value of L2 by W, so if you take this curve and proceed on the left side, then you will get F1 to 2. So F1 to 2 you will get as 0.2. So exactly when you mark, you will get at 0.2. So the view factor from sidewall to the from between the end walls to the floor is nothing but 0.2 is calculated in this fashion. Similarly, F1 to 3 between sidewall and floor. So this is the end wall. Now we have to take the sidewall. Now what is the sidewall? So this is the sidewall. So sidewall is having 1.7 meter width. So here for sidewall, W is equal to 1.7 meter and L2 is equal to 2 meter, that is height, and L1 will become 1.5 meter. So L1 will become 1.5 meter. Now in this case, if we find out L2 by W. So L2 by W, which is equal to 2 meter by 1.7 meter. 2 divided by 1.7 meter. So 2 divided by 1.7 meter is 1.176. So which is nothing but 1.176. 1.176 is nothing but L2 by W. This is x axis. Now here the curve is L1 by W. So L1 by W is equal to 1.5 meter divided by 1.7. So 1.5 divided by 1.7 is 0.86. So which is equal to 0.86. So the curve is 0.86. Where it is? Somewhere here, 0.8 and 0.7. So somewhere here you will get a curve of value 0.86. 0.86. This is the curve we have to refer. And L2 by W is 1.176. So this is now somewhere here. So with this, when I proceed, you will get the point here and towards the left. So here you will get the value that is as 0.235. Now this one is 0.235. So this is the view factor for the between side wall and the floor. So in this way we can calculate by using the graph the view factors for between the end walls and floor and between the side walls and the floor. Now heat flow from end walls to the floor can be calculated by this equation. So how to calculate? First we need to find out black body emissive power of the side walls, end walls, that is EB2, that is which is equal to sigma into T2 to the power of 4, that is 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into 523 Kelvin to the power of 4. Similarly, EB1, which is equal to sigma into T1 to the power of 4. This is nothing but Stefan Boltzmann law. 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into 403 to the power of 4. Resistance can be calculated as 1 minus 0.82, that is epsilon, divided by area, that is 1.7 into 1.5 meter into again epsilon. 0.82 plus 1 divided by, that is area again, 1.7 into 1.5 into the view factor F1 to 2 plus 1 minus of 0.82 epsilon divided by area 1.5 meter into 2 meter into the emissivity 0.82. Now substituting these values in the equation here, what they are given, that is sigma into area into T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4, that it is also written as EB1 minus EB2 divided by 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by A1 epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by area A1 into view factor F1 to 3 plus 1 minus of epsilon 3 divided by area A3 into epsilon 3, which is equal to 2746.6 divided by 2.12, which is nothing but 1295.6 watt per centimeter. Therefore, Q 2 to 1 is equal to 2 times of Q 2 to 1, which is equal to 2591.2 watts. That is the total heat transfer from 2 to 1. There are two side walls, therefore 2 times, therefore 2591.2 watts. Now heat flow from side walls to the floor is calculated as Q3 to 1, the same equation, EB3 minus EB1 divided by 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by A1 into epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by A1 into view factor F1 to 3 plus 1 divided 1 minus of epsilon 3 divided by A3 into epsilon 3, which is equal to 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8, that is sigma, multiplied by T3 to the power of 4, that is 523 to the power of 4 minus 403 to the power of 4, whole divided by 1 minus epsilon 1 0.82 divided by 1.7 into 1.5 into 0.82 plus 1 minus of 0.82 divided by 1.7 into 1.5 into 0.82, which is equal to 1509.7 or 1509.7 watt per second. So QT3 to 1 is calculated as 2 times of 1509.7, that is 3019.5 watts. Now similarly, heat flow from the ceiling to the floor can be calculated as follows. That is Q4 to 1 is equal to EB4 minus EB1, that is emissive power of 4 and emissive power of 1, that can be calculated by sigma into T1 to the power of 4 minus sigma into T2 to the power of 4 divided by 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by A1 into epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by A1 into view factor F1 to 4 plus 1 minus of epsilon 4 divided by A4 into epsilon 4, which is equal to 2746.6 divided by 0.0861 plus 1 divided by 1.7 into 1.5 into 0.14 plus 1 minus of 0.82 divided by 1.7 into 1.5 into 0.82, which is equal to 923.72 watt. Therefore, total heat flow to the floor is Q234 to 1 is the summation of all the above heat flow. So that is from side walls and from the ceiling, everything, that is 2591.2 plus 3019.5 plus 923.7, which is equal to 6534.4 watts of total heat flow from the walls and the ceiling to the floor. So we'll continue with one more problem, that is a furnace radiation at 2000 Kelvin, treating it as a black body radiation. Calculate the monochromatic radiant flux density at 1 micrometer wavelength and wavelength at which emission is maximum and the corresponding radiant flux density, total emissive power and wavelength lambda such that the emission from 0 to lambda is equal to the emission from 0 to lambda. So this is what we have to calculate. They have given the temperature, wavelength for monochromatic radiant flux. So we have to find out monochromatic flux. We have to find out wavelength at which emission is maximum and total emissive power and wavelength to lambda for emission. Now for this one, from Planck's law of distribution, we know that the black body emissive power is given as, for a particular wavelength, C1 into lambda to the power of minus 5 divided by exponential C2 divided by lambda t minus of 1. C1 and C2 are constants whose values are 0.374 into 10 to the power of minus 15 into my 1 micrometer, that is 1 into 10 to the power of minus 6 to the power of minus 5, divided by exponential 1.4388 into 10 to the power of minus 2, divided by 1 into 10 to the power of minus 6 into 2000, that is temperature, minus 1, which is nothing but 2.81 into 10 to the power of 7 watt per meter square per meter wavelength. From Wien's displacement law, we know that lambda max into T is equal to 2.898 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Rearranging, lambda max is equal to 2.898 into 10 to the power of minus 3 divided by 2000 Kelvin, which is nothing but 1.449 into 10 to the power of minus 6 meter. Now we can calculate maximum radiant flux density as follows. The equation for this one is 1.285 into 10 to the power of minus 5 into T to the power of 5, which is nothing but 1.285 into 10 to the power of minus 5 into 2000 Kelvin to the power of 5, which is nothing but, after simplification, we will get 4.11 into 10 to the power of 11 watt per meter square. That is, per meter we will get the wavelength, that is 4.11 into 10 to the power of 11 watts of radiant flux density. So we have already studied the Stefan-Boltzmann law. From Stefan-Boltzmann law, we can write E is equal to sigma B, that is black body emissive power. Sorry, this is a Stefan-Boltzmann constant into T to the power of 4, that is 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into absolute temperature 2000 Kelvin to the power of 4, which is nothing but 907200 watt per meter square, or 907.2 kilowatt per meter square. Next one, the emission in the bandwidth 0 to lambda is half of total emission from 0 to infinity. Therefore, fractional emissive power is 0.5, corresponding to the temperature product as it is read from the table, from the data handbook. Therefore, F 0 to lambda is 0.5. Now, the wavelength is approximately 4100 micrometer Kelvin. That is nothing but the product of lambda into T, that is wavelength into temperature. Wavelength into temperature is 4100 micrometer Kelvin. Rearranging this one, we will get lambda is equal to 4100 divided by temperature T. That is, lambda is equal to 4100 divided by 2000 Kelvin. So finally, we will get the wavelength, that is 2.05 micrometer. So now this is the emission in the bandwidth, that is 0 to lambda. So this is the fractional emissive power, which is 0.5 times of in this range, means 0 to lambda. So this is another example. The example is like this. Consider a surface exposed to solar radiation. At a given time, the direct and diffuse components of solar radiation are GD is equal to 400 and G suffix small d is equal to 300 watt per meter square. And direct radiation makes 20 degree with the normal to the surface. The surface temperature is observed to be 320 Kelvin and at that time, and assuming an effective sky temperature of 260 Kelvin, determine the net rate of radiation heat transfer for these cases. So there are four cases are given, where the first two cases are having gray absorber surface and gray reflector surface, and the second two cases, that is third and fourth cases, are having selective absorber surface, selective reflector surface, and for each cases the absorptivity and emissivity are given. So solar radiation generally will have two components, direct radiation and diffuse radiation. So both are given. Direct radiation is 400 watt per meter square and diffuse radiation is 300 watt per meter square. So the radiation makes an angle of 20 degree with the surface. The surface temperature is 320 Kelvin and sky temperature is 260 Kelvin they have given. We have to find out net rate of radiation for the four different cases which are given below. Now, a surface is exposed to the solar and sky radiation, that is the direct and diffuse radiation. The net rate of radiation heat transfer is to be determined for four different combinations of emissivities and solar absorptivities. First, we need to find out solar radiation, that is total radiation, that is equal to G suffix solar is equal to GD cos theta, that is the direct radiation multiplied by cos theta, plus diffuse radiation G suffix small d, that is 400 watt per meter square cos 20 degree plus 300 watt per meter square, which is equal to 676 watt per meter square. Then the net rate of radiation heat transfer for each cases are determined as follows. Now you can see that Q net radiation is nothing but absorptivity multiplied by total radiation, that is G suffix solar, plus emissivity multiplied by sigma into T sky to the power of 4 minus Ts to the power of 4. For the first case, alpha S, that is absorptivity, is 0.9 and emissivity is 0.9, and the body is gray absorber body or gray absorber surface. Substituting these values of 0.9 as alpha S and epsilon 0.9 along with the G solar is equal to 676 watt per meter square, we will have Q net radiation for the first case as 0.9 into 676 watt per meter square plus 0.9 into 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 watt per meter square Kelvin to the power of 4 multiplied by 260 Kelvin to the power of 4 minus 320 Kelvin to the power of 4. So the answer for the first case is 307 watt per meter square. Similarly, for the second case, alpha S is 0.1 and emissivity is 0.1. That is, gray reflector surface is considered. Substituting the values of these two, alpha S 0.1 and emissivity 0.1, along with solar radiation 676 watt per meter square In this equation, we will get Q net radiation is equal to 0.1 into 676 watt per meter square plus 0.1 into 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 watt per meter square Kelvin to the power of 4 multiplied by 260 Kelvin to the power of 4 minus 320 Kelvin to the power of 4, which is equal to 34 watt per meter square. Similarly, for the third case, alpha s is 0.9 and epsilon is 0.1, and substituting these values in the equation, Q net radiation is equal to alpha s 0.9 into GD 676 watt per meter square plus epsilon 0.1 into sigma 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 watt per meter square Kelvin to the power of 4 into 260 Kelvin to the power of 4 minus 320 Kelvin to the power of 4, which is equal to 575 watt per meter square. For the next case, alpha s is equal to 0.9 and emissivity 0.9, that is selective reflector surface. Substituting these values along with the GD, total solar radiation 676 watt per meter square multiplied by 0.1 alpha s plus 0.9 epsilon into sigma 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 watt per meter square Kelvin to the power of 4 into 260 to the power of 4 minus 320 to the power of 4, we will get the answer as minus 234 watt per meter square. Now in this problem, we have to note that the surface of an ordinary gray material of high absorptivity gains heat at a rate of 307 watt per meter square. Now you can see this is the first case, that is gray absorber surface will have the 307 watt per meter square of radiation. The amount of heat gain increases to 575 watt per meter square when the surface is coated with selective material that has same absorptivity for solar radiation. So absorptivity is the same, whereas you can see here the emissivity for the first case is 0.9. Now here in this case, emissivity is reduced by selecting with the selective material, by coating with the selective material. So the radiation increases. So the amount of heat gain increases. But a low emissivity for infrared radiation. Also note that surface of an ordinary gray material of high reflectivity still gains heat at a rate of 34 watt per meter square. So this is gray reflector surface will have 34 watt per meter square of energy received on the surface. When the surface is coated with selective material that has same reflectivity, the solar radiation, but a high emissivity for infrared radiation, the surface loses 234 watt per meter square. So this negative symbol indicates that when it is coated with selective material that has the same reflectivity, it loses more energy. Therefore, it loses 234 watt per meter square or minus 234 watt per meter square. Therefore, the temperature of the surface will decrease when the selective reflector surface is used. So selective reflector surface, when we use for any materials, we can expect the lower temperature, or the temperature of the surface will decrease. So this is one example of different absorptivities and emissivities. And we'll solve one more example of different type. A gray surface has an emissivity at a temperature of 550 Kelvin source. If the source is opaque, calculate its reflectivity for a black body radiation coming from a 550 Kelvin source. A small 25 millimeter square hole is made in a thin walled door of surface whose inside walls are 920 Kelvin, and if the emissivity of the walls are 0.72, calculate the rate at which radiant energy escapes from the surface, escapes from the furnace through the hole to the room. So what they have given, there is a gray surface whose emissivity has an emissivity at a temperature of 550 Kelvin source. So this is the source temperature. If the surface is opaque, so it is assumed that the surface is opaque, calculate its reflectivity, rho we have to calculate, that is reflectivity, for a black body radiation coming from the 550 Kelvin source. Assuming a black body radiation, what is the reflectivity at a temperature of 550 Kelvin from this gray surface? There is a small hole, that is a square 25 millimeter hole is there, and the temperature of inside walls is considered as 920 Kelvin, and emissivity of the walls is 0.72. Calculate the rate at which radiant energy escapes from the furnace through the hole. So how much energy radiates through this hole, square hole, from the furnace, that we have to calculate in this problem. The requirement that all the radiant energy striking any surface may be accounted for, alpha plus rho plus tau is equal to zero. So we already studied this one. So for any surface where energy is striking, so absorptivity plus reflectivity plus transmittivity is equal to 1. So this we have studied in the theory part of solar radiation, different bodies. In this case, it is given as opaque body or opaque surface. For the opaque surface, we have transmittivity tau is equal to 0. And again, we can write absorptivity is equal to emissivity, which is equal to 0.35. See, in the problem it is given, the emissivity is 0.35 is given. So, since it is a opaque surface, alpha is equal to emissivity is equal to 0.35. This is in accordance with Kirchhoff law. So this is what the Kirchhoff law states, that absorptivity equals to emissivity under same temperature conditions. So here the surface temperature is same, that is 550 Kelvin. So it is given in the problem. So for the same temperature, for the same temperature, you can see that absorptivity is equal to emissivity. So this is what, as per the Kirchhoff law. Or we can say that when the surface is under thermal equilibrium, the absorptivity will be equal to the emissivity. So therefore, this above equation is rearranged as follows. Now we can see that rho is equal to what? Rho is equal to 1 minus alpha plus, sorry, alpha minus tau, or it is rearranged as rho is equal to 1 minus common alpha plus tau, which is equal to 1 minus alpha is equal to 0.35, that we have substituted, plus tau is 0 for the opaque surface, that also we have substituted here. The answer will be 0.65, means rho is equal to how much? Rho is equal to 0.65 we will get by substituting these values. Now, the surface reflects 65% of incident energy coming from the surface or source at 550 Kelvin. So, from this we can say that, so 65% of incident energy is reflected by the surface, that is a opaque surface. This energy is coming from the source, which is maintained at a temperature of 550 Kelvin. And the next thing is that we need to calculate how much radiant energy is escaping through the hole. So the hole is given as a small square hole. This is a square hole. So the square hole is having a dimension of 25 millimeter into 25 millimeter. This acts as a black body, and according to the rate at which the radiant energy leaves the hole is given as E is equal to sigma black body into area into T to the power of 4. That is, sigma is nothing but Stefan Boltzmann constant, which is a 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 watt per meter square Kelvin to the power of 4. Now you can see this is what 25 centimeter into 25 centimeter, because this is a square hole. This is a square hole. For square hole, 0.25, that is 25 centimeter into 0.25, that is nothing but 25 centimeter, will give you the area of the square hole, that is A, multiplied by T to the power of 4. So temperature is given. So how much wall temperature they have given? The inside walls are at 920 degree Kelvin, what they have mentioned. So according to this, so absolute temperature is 920 to the power of 4, that we have to substitute here. So after simplification of this one, we will get 25.38 watts of energy that leaves the surface, or that is the radiant energy escaping through the furnace through this square hole is 25.38 watts. So here we have to note that the data about the emissivity of the wall is not needed. So there is no necessary of data, that is the emissivity value of the walls, so that is not required to solve this problem. So in this way we can solve the problem of this type if we know the values of absorptivity, transmittivity and emissivity, and also if we know the Kirchhoff's law, and this one is Stefan Boltzmann's law, we can solve the problem and calculate the radiant energy escaping through the hole. So with this I'll wind up today's session, and I will continue in the next session with some more type of examples. Thank you very much.